Hello guys, welcome back. In this video we will discuss the last topic that is remaining for this entire course, and the topic is file handling in C. Once we are done with this video, we will concentrate on two videos that will focus on making of a small mini project using C. So this is basically our last video, and this file handling chapter is actually very important. You will get basically these kind of chapters are important when it comes to making small projects in C. Otherwise, file handling is not as much as important as you would say arrays or pointers or structures, etc. But anyways, you have to study this chapter as well. So the first thing that I would like to first discuss today is the file operations. Now, files in C support various kind of operations. The operations can be append, write, read, close, open, etc. and etc. So the first one we have creating a new file using the fopen function along with attributes like a, a plus, ww plus. So these four things, that is a, a plus, ww plus, I will explain after some while when we discuss file modes in C. But as of now, the important thing is to understand that creating a new file using fopen is one of the file operations that we can perform. Next, we have opening an existing file using fopen in either append, read or write mode. So if you already have a file that exists in your system, then you can directly open that file using fopen in any of these three modes, either append or read or write mode. Furthermore, we have reading from a file using fscanf or fgetc. So these are the two methods. We also use fgets. These are the 3-4 methods that we use in order to read strings from file, or basically to read data from file. Next, we have writing to a file. So writing means basically editing the content of the file. So we do that same thing using that same software. We do that using that same thing like fprintf or fputs, etc. So that was reading from file. The fscanf or fgetc we use for reading from file, and writing to a file we use fprintf or fputs functions. And lastly, we have moving cursor to a specific location. Say suppose you have a long text, that is a 1000 line text, and you maybe want to go to line number say 639 or 650, whatever. So you'll move to that location by using this function, that is fseek. Okay, and obviously if we are opening any file, we have to close it so as to maintain the integrity of the file. We must not have any data loss that occurring anywhere inside the file or whatever. So that's why it's a good practice to always try and close the file whichever the file we have opened. Okay, so if I open say a file called abc, if I open that file, or rather if I if we have a file say abc.c, and if we open it using fopen, then if there is any data, then that data may get lost or may get mismatched if we do not close the file properly. If any unexpected error occurs in the program, then the program terminates, okay, unexpectedly. Next, we have the various file modes. So the first mode is obviously the R and R plus. These two modes are used in order to, if you want to read from the file, that is, see, we have R and R plus. What both of them basically perform the same task, but the difference between the both is in the fact that if you use file mode R, then if the file does not already exist in your system, then the system will not create any file. But if you use F plus, then the system automatically creates a file for you. Okay, so that's the difference between R and R plus. Similarly, we also have W and W plus. In W, what happens is the file gets opened for writing. Okay, we do not, we may not have the file in the memory as well. If we have, then that file will be opened from the memory, otherwise a new file will be created, just like this one, R and R plus, just like in the case of R and R plus. Okay, next thing is A and A plus. So A opens the file for append mode, or it opens the file in append In append mode, if you want to write any data to the file, or if you want to write any data to the end of the file, okay, that is what append means. Append means if you have a 6-line code or 7-line of text, then your data will get inserted at the end of whatever you we have. Okay, so A and A plus, A plus, W plus, and R plus, etc. These will create new files if they do not already exist in the system. And you must note this point that if you want to perform all the operations of files in binary, then you'll have to append B at the end of all the modes. For example, if you want to read from a binary file, then you'll have to write read minus B, and actually not minus B, rather we will write RB, okay, R space B, R, then next space will be B. That means if binary operations need to be performed, then B is appended at the end of various file modes. So these are basically our different file modes. So if you write R and you want to get the operations performed in whatever language, say binary operations, that is binary file operations, then in that case you will have to write B along with R. So essentially our file mode will be RB or RB plus. If you want to write to the file, then your file mode will be WB and WB plus. Okay, so these are few things about file modes. And over here I have written two small code snippets just to save time. Okay, so this first code snippet, what it does is it creates a new file. I do not already have this file called temprite dot whatever the dot txt. You can have any file name dot dat dot maybe rtf, any supported file format. Okay, so if you do that, then obviously in this case, see what happens is I've just written this code. So hash include stdio.h, this is my first line. What we can do is we can just directly go over here and understand the code. So I've as usual included that customary header file. Along with that, if you can see, I have made a file pointer, that is file star fp. So this is my file pointer basically. Okay, what is the task of this file pointer? This pointer will constantly this file pointer fp stands for file pointer. So this will help us to constantly read data from the file, either read data from the file or write data to the file, whatever it is. Okay, so that is the use of fp. Now fp is equal to f open temprite.txt comma w or w plus. I have written w plus because I did not have this file already created. Okay, I did not have this file, that is temprite.txt, in my memory. So if I do not have that file, then using w plus will just create a file of this name and then write the corresponding data, whatever you have to write. So once this file is opened, you can perform file operations. So the first operation, if you can see, I am inserting some data into that file, that is fprintf fp comma writing to temprite.txt file using fprintf. So this was my fprintf. Similarly, we have this fputs as well. If you put this, then also your purpose will be served, okay, using fputs. So let us just compile this code once and let us see what the output is. Obviously we won't be actually able to see any output as such. So our process started and it shows that process ended in 0 seconds itself, but that is not the case. In the background, what happened is this file got created, and inside this file we had these two functions also. Okay, so that was your writing to a file. Next we have reading from file. So in case of reading from a file, I have written two different code blocks. Okay, two different blocks of code. So our file, we have included our customary header file. Other than that, what you have to do is see file star fp, and your idea is to read the file, basically read the content of the file from the maybe anywhere, say whatever is the file. So if you want to read the data from that particular file name, then you obviously need to have a pointer to that file. So the pointer to that file is our this thing, file star fp. So fp is equal to f open, and this is the file name which I want to read. Inside this I have maintained a loop, that is while ch is equal to f get c fp not equal to uf. That means repeat the loop until I go to the end of the file. If I go to the end of the file, then our loop will break. So this was one method. Let me just show it to you, the output of this file, output of this code. So that is what we had in that file basically. See, just now I had written to that file. So the first statement was writing to temprite.txt using fprintf, and the second one says writing to same thing using fputs. So basically both these functions are correct. If you want to, I mean, you are free to choose whatever version you want or whatever method you want to use in order to write the file, write into the file. Next, what we have is we have this method also. You can also use this method if you want to perform any operations on file. So let's compile this. Okay. So that's giving us the same result as before. Okay. So both the things are basically the same. So you can follow any one of them which you find easier to use maybe. Okay. Other than this, what I can do is, see, I had just created a file. So that file must be there somewhere there in my memory, computer memory. So if you can see over here, we have one file whose name is temp2weird. Let's open this file. And inside this file, you can see we have writing to temprite.txt file using fprintf. And the second one you can see writing to temprite.file.txt second one, or fputs basically. So these are the two methods which you can call. So coming back to this code, this was the code snippet for writing to a file, and this was the code snippet for file read. Okay. Other than that, we probably do not have anything much for this video. So over here, yes, I have already explained what's happening inside this code, and then I place this f close fp right at the end. If it works out perfectly fine, no problem at all. You can all try with any of these two versions. Okay, we have two versions or two methods how we can read from a file. You can write, you can use any method as per your choice. So that is all for this video. Thank you. We shall meet once again for two more videos in the next two videos while we are doing the project. Thank you.